Good evening, everybody. One of the highlights at the Black Hills Stock Show every year is the North American Sheepdog Trials. It's a chance to watch some amazing animals show off their skills. Andrew Lynn took in the action today and has more.
Meet Vic, an 8-year-old collie from Faith, South Dakota.
He's made the switch from pet to all of a sudden now I gotta work. You know, you can almost see that light bulb switch in his head, you know. He drops the toys and we're all about the sheep.
Vic, along with 44 other dogs, competed in today's sheepdog prelim trials at the Kearsett Event Center. Handlers like Tammy guided their dogs through a series of obstacles to reflect everyday life herding sheep.
So I went and bought some sheep and unloaded them, and my husband was like, "What's that?" I'm like, "Those are sheep. We're going to do sheep dogs, and I have a puppy."
Meet Nan, who's originally from across the pond but now resides in Manitoba, Canada.
She's a 6-year-old dog that I imported from Ireland. You know, her pedigree says she should be good, and I know the fellow that has her, that owned her in Ireland, and just felt it was a good place to source a dog from.
Ferris and his pup, like many handlers and their dogs, have a great bond away from their work.
Always is watching to see what I'm doing, and she's willing to just take part in whether I'm fixing a tractor or whether I'm working sheep in the yards.
Training at home for events like these is very different than entering the competition space. The course is never identical, which is an adjustment for everyone.
When you're practicing at home, you have to set it up. You have to set up obstacles. You have to set up different situations. Mix it up day to day. You know, and it's not necessarily training for the course, but you're training for certain skills.
You train your dog on verbal as well as whistle commands. I find the whistles for me work the best on her, so I use mostly whistles, but she does work on both.
The sheepdog community is close-knit, and events like these give participants a chance to connect through their sport.
It's a hobby. It's fun. I have to remind myself to have fun at it, enjoy it, you know, meet the people, visit, you know, have fun with the dogs.
Reporting in Rapid City, alongside Vic and Nan, I'm Andrew Lund.
Thank you very much, Andrew. Now, Rodeo Rapid City cranked up over the weekend with the PRCA Extreme Bulls and Extreme Bronx. Florida's Clayton Sellers won Extreme Bulls with an 86-point ride. Oklahoma's Jeter Lawrence finished second with an 84.5 at the Extreme Bronx competition. Leon Fountain and Q Taylor tied for the top spot with 86.5-point rides. Rodeo Rapid City rolls on from the Summit Arena Thursday night with a full PRCA performance. Today, Jack, we're going to talk a little USD, SDSU basketball. The USD women had a nice win on Saturday. We'll hear from the Coyotes coming up tonight at 9 and 10.
And finally, know the Super Bowl matchup down to the final two.
That's right. We're down to just one game left on the NFL schedule. Two teams left. The 49ers and the Chiefs got wins yesterday. The Chiefs just keep getting it done. Knocked off the Ravens by the score of 17-10 yesterday. And 49ers with a comeback win over the Lions. They were down 24-7 in that game. San Francisco came back to win. So 49ers and the Chiefs meeting up in the Super Bowl, not this Sunday, but a week from Sunday.
All right. Thank you very much, Vic. Well,